Oh, he's a hobbyist beast, but he is adorable. I'm going to take him.
Hey guys, my name is Missy, and I'm a full-time reseller, a thrifter, a picker, or better yet, a treasure hunter. I love digging and hunting for treasures in the wild, just searching for that perfect piece. You can find me picking garage sales, thrift shops, flea markets, and yes, even some curbs. So come along on this adventure, and let's go do some picking. Hey guys, it's Missy with Junk to be Loved, and I am back with another picking video for you guys today. I am back at the bins for another treasure hunt. It's been a while since I've been here, so let's get our butts in there and see what we can find today. Well, it rained and stormed, and it's a gloomy day. It's very, very cloudy. See those wicked clouds? We're supposed to get storms again later on this afternoon, so. All right, here we go for a treasure hunt. All right, let's see what's in these glass bins, shall we? I've still got, oh, that's heavy. That's really, really heavy. I've still got a lot of pixies to sell in a live sale. I need to have another live sale soon. Because if you like pixies, then you'll definitely want to tune into my live sale. Oh, he's a hobbyist beast, but he is adorable. I'm going to take him because they did a fantastic job on him. He's cute. He'll go in my cart. He's my first item of the day. Here's an old peanuts can. There's a bunch of old tins. The last time. Should I take the peanut can? It's a little rusty. That side's not too bad. I'll put it in my cart and we'll think about it. We'll think about Gary's peanuts. Ooh, careful, Missy. I don't want any of the Quaker Oats tins. There's a bunch of bears in here. Ornaments. She's adorable. I'll put her into a treasure bag. Well, unless Mom wants her. Mom might actually want her. She's got tiny, tiny little Chippy on her. Ooh, trinkets and treasures in this one. Little praying girls. That's a cute little trinket box. That's adorable. I'll take that. Put the little trinket box in there. She's cute. She's home co. But I'm being picky. I'm being real, real picky. Well, sort of. Some blue dishes.
Ooh, that's broken. That'd be careful with that. That's adorable too. Cute. Oh, I'm like stuck on a string. I think there's string stuck on my wheel. Like fishing line stuck on my wheel down there. With tiny little hands, babies touch our hearts forever. Aww, that's adorable. Oh, that's a tiny little ceramic egg. I'll put it in a treasure bag. It doesn't weigh anything. Stick it in that planter. All right, well, and a bunch of silverware, which I don't need. So let's go look at the hard. Okay. It should have a tag on it. Toss it to me. I don't know. How old do you guys think that is? I don't, here, Todd. I was just putting it on video. I think it's probably from like the 70s, maybe 80s. That's cute, little wind chime. You're rich. Cart got stuck. Look at what I just found. Look at this cute, cute baby. Oh, I love her. She's absolutely adorable. Going in my cart. I found a few other small things. You'll have to wait and see. Oh, that is gonna go into a treasure bag. Hope we don't fall through the hole. There's a bunch of little babies in here. Says China. Whoa, that's weird. That's really weird doll. She's mismatched, like all of her. This is plastic, these are rubber. Her head is, I have no idea what. That's weird. Doll utensils. I don't know what that is. Made in China. Oh, that's a cute baby. That one's different looking. I'll put that one in there. Maybe I'll do another doll lot.
find more babies. So, I found the tag and it was completely wrong. It's from 1990. It says right there. It's not gonna focus. 1990, made in China. And he has a smell to him. So, Todd didn't want him. I don't want him. He's staying behind. But look at that funky shoe. It's weird.
It says, baby pile of shit. Nothing great.
These are cute. These little pins, still in the package, and they don't weigh anything. They're Blossom Bucket ink. So those are adorable. Let me see if I can find any more of those in here. Another one of these. These are from Germany. I found two of them so far. Found a few little things in there. It's a little rock girl. Pretty cute for a treasure bag, maybe. With her little googly eyes. I like her. Think about her. Yes, they're taking away the glass. They're gonna bring out some new glass. It's my favorite. All right, here they come with the glass. I don't really see much. There's a ton of people here waiting. Well, I didn't get much out of the glass bins, you guys. Just a couple small little things. That is it. There was nothing in there.
Ready? And one. And two. And one. And two. And one. And two.
What in the world is this mask? It is like a creepy wolf mask. Creepy. I don't know if it's old or not, but it's cool. And a clock with coins. He did. Look at that monster. He's got a tag. He's weird looking. His eyes are just like stickers on there. Oh, that would have been adorable. This is, it's just the cover.
There's no inside to it, but isn't that so cute? I think that's adorable. All right, it's time for them to take away these hard goods and bring out some new ones. All right, here they come with new bins.
I mean, every now and then I actually find you excited about the little one.
Okay, here's what rolled out in front of me, so I'm not seeing that. You guys want to see how busy it is in here today? Ready? Look, here we go. Here we go. You can't find a spot. Craziness. That old trick-or-treat bag. It's like an old Furby. And some party supplies. You want that octopus? You grab that octopus.
Wow.
I didn't mean it like that. Oh my goodness. See what I do with it here, guys. It's so funny. What is this down here? Oh, nothing I want. So I'm looking in these new bins. And I see this box, right? Just looks like a box. On the side,
there's the other one.
It says Denmark. I open them up, and it is all the set of these amazing, it's hard to do with one hand, ornaments. They're complete, perfect condition. They're from Denmark. These are very rare. These are really, really amazing. So that was an amazing find here in the Goodwill bins. That makes me super happy. So I'll add them to my cart full of treasures. So I've been here for a few hours now. Time twang thing. It's new. It's a new toy from 2017. I'll put it back in there just in case somebody wants it. But yeah. All right. Well, I think we're going to go check out. And get right into the haul video. Another little pair of scissors I'll add. To a treasure bag. Get those hairs off of them. I like adding these little scissors to treasure bags. I have another little pair in there too. Yep. I think we are gonna go check out. Okay, well, right when I was getting ready to leave, they brought out a new soft and a new hard. So I did pretty well today. I about half filled my card up. So let's go home and get right into the haul. Okay, we made it back from the Goodwill bins and I ended up spending $25. Not too bad. I got a big sack full of stuff that you guys didn't see in the video. Oh my goodness. I got some good stuff. I am super, super excited. So let's just get right into this haul. Okay, so right on top, I put the birds. I put these birds. They are marked. Are you guys gonna be able to see it? There we go. They're from Denmark. Even the little package has little birdies on it. And you open these up. Oh my goodness. These are so cute. They're all in there. All of them. And look at these cutie patootie things. Let me take one out. Aren't they adorable? There's three red, three white. They're marked on the bottom right there. They're stamped. And I was only able to find this. That's it. I know first dibs is, you know, things are priced very expensive on there and stuff like that. But that's all I could find. I couldn't find any other ones listed anywhere else at all. Like, that was it. So I love those. Aren't they? They're absolutely amazing. So amazing. It's like an artist did these. An artist made those. So that was really, really exciting. I love those. And then I found this. I was able to grab this. It needs a good cleaning. It is filthy. It's really, really dusty, dirty. I need to clean it up. But this is a vintage record holder. Love these, very retro and fun and really collectible. So I picked up that. And then I was able to find this beautiful tablecloth. It's like a towel, the towel material. You can see it's like a towel. But isn't that gorgeous and beautiful? I will, so pretty. I will lay it all out right there and put a picture in the measurement so you guys can see what it looks like. But that is really cool. And then I found a couple really cute little notebooks. I thought these were fun. Brand new. Never written in. Aren't they cute? So there's that one. And then this one. I like them. They're like made to look old. So I thought those were cute and fun. And then these box of cards. I love the box. I think the box would just look fun sitting up in display, you know, by itself. It's in really good condition. And then inside the box is a whole bunch of really cute, kitschy greeting cards. So there's a whole bunch of different ones in here. And even some get well card. Oh, look at this one. Cute. So there's all kinds of different ones in here. Just different. You know. So that's fun little variety of cards. I like that box. I really do. Then I picked up this stinking cute little vintage coloring book. It is by Whitman. It's in perfect condition, you know, a little bit of wear here and there, but nothing too major. Basically perfect condition. It's never been colored in at all. I just think that's so fun and adorable. And I don't, did it have a date on there? MCM. LXI. MCMLXI. So that's so cute. So that. And then I picked up this little green handled thing. This will go into a pick three sale. a bunch of stuff, I think, for a pick three sale, maybe. This little cute little vintage iron pick three sale. I picked up this vintage doll. I really like her. Look at the fabric. Somebody made her. She is so cute, so adorable. She doesn't have any legs, so you could sit her. She wasn't made with legs, so you could sit her like on top of something, you know? I just think she's really, really, really cute. I like her. I think I got a lot of dolls, actually. Oh, I picked myself up a pair of shorts. Found myself a pair of shorts, so that's always nice. I picked up this little cute little angel. She's got one little chippy on her wing right there. And so I'm going to gift her to my mama. See, she's bone china. She's so cute and adorable. She's holding a little paintbrush. So I think my mom will probably want this little girl. So she's going to go to mom. And then I found this little thing. It's a little miniature hedgehog type thing, ornament, hanging thing. But I picked it up because on the bottom, oops, upside down. So there we go. You can see it's marked and it's made in West Germany. It says West Germany on there. Okay, my dog is making noises. And then I picked up these two little German ornaments. They're marked on the bottom. 19, I can't see. Maybe they're made in China. I don't know, but they look like the little German girls. I thought they were cute and adorable. So they, maybe they'll go back for a Christmas sale. Who knows? Bunch of stuff for a treasure bag. I stuck it in this little cup here. This little doll, she'll go into a treasure bag. This little character, a little vintage barrette, an old one, that'll go into a treasure bag. I mean, I'll probably just go ahead and put these in that treasure bag as well. Might as well. This will go into a treasure bag. This little Shopkin, or little mini brands. I think that's what it is, a little mini brands doll. That will go into a treasure bag. This little ceramic egg. That'll go into a treasure bag. I thought that was cute. Oh my gosh, what else did I stick in here? Oh, this is definitely going to a treasure bag. When I seen it, I have the same one hanging on my visor, and so I thought someone else might like it as well. Never drive faster than your guardian angel can fly. I love that. I love that saying, and so I have this same exact clip hanging in my Jeep. So that's going to go into a treasure bag. And then these are really, really neat. Now, these I might sell separately. They're vintage pins. Two vintage pins. They're old. Let's see. So I might sell those separately. I don't know. Actually, I'll probably sit those in there because I probably will sell those separately. And if not, then they'll go into a trash bag. And treasure bag, that little miniature thing. This little guy's cool. He's wooden. I don't know what he's for, but he's probably going to go into a pick three sale. He's a wooden guy. I don't know what he's supposed to hold, but I like him. I thought he was cute. A little cutie. She's adorable. Love her. I picked up a vintage troll. Oh, look at it. It's a treasure troll. Treasure troll. So cute. This one's in really good condition too. Little, maybe needs a little bath. Not really though. I don't think so. It's pretty much in good shape. So I just thought that was so cute. So that.
treasure bag, cute little Lake of the Ozarks souvenir piece, cute little baby. Ooh. Oh my goodness, it's missing its arms and its legs, but I mean, come on, I couldn't pass that up, right? That's adorable. So that'll probably go into the vintage doll lot, along with this girl. She's stinking cute and adorable. Never seen that one before. She'll go into the vintage doll lot. And this is gonna go into maybe a treasure bag or a vintage toy bag. I don't know, I haven't decided. Probably just go ahead and put it in the treasure bag. Then I picked up this. I love this. I thought it was Relpo at first. It looks like a Relpo Halloween planter to me. It's in really good condition. There's no chips or cracks, but somebody made it. So they did a good job. They made it in 1977. They did a very, very good job, but I love that mold. Isn't that so adorable? That is the cutest thing ever. Love that piece. Then this will probably go into a pick three sale. I picked Luke up a couple golf balls. He's always looking for golf balls because he's losing them when he plays his golf. And then a ring, a really cute beaded ring. It's all beaded. Absolutely gorgeous and beautiful. Look at it. And it fits around anybody's finger because it's kind of like elasticy. So isn't that pretty? I love that. This is cute. This vintage pick. It's the poodles. So in its case, so that will go into a pick three sale. And then two vintage, wrapped up in these scissors. Well, these two pairs of scissors, I don't know where the other one is, but these are gonna go into a treasure bag. And then I picked up two costume jewelry necklaces. They're really, really pretty. Oops, this one's twisted. Hold on. Come on. So this one's longer. So if you, assuming you're supposed to double it up, there we go. Aren't they pretty? So, so, so pretty. Love the red, love the purple. Bling, bling. I picked myself up a fly swatter. These always come in handy, always, especially in the summertime. Flies are bad this year, really, really bad. So that, this cute little glass jar, that will go into pick three sale. This is awesome. It's a little trinket box and it still has the Bible inside. It's a little church. And then it has the Bible. Oh, am I upside down? There we go. See, isn't that neat? A lot of the times when you find these little trinket boxes, they won't have the trinkets in them anymore. So this one does. No chips, no cracks. Cute, cute, cute. Treasure bag. Little vintage Florida shaker. This little music box. Love this. It is a Swiss music box. And I'm a dum-dum. I'm the dum-dum that didn't check to see if it worked before I bought it. And it doesn't work. So probably garage sale pile. It goes, unfortunately. Yep, those are yours, Luke. This little compact. I love the enameled butterfly. It's a nice mirrored compact. This cute owl. It's a single shaker. There was only one of them in there. It's stamped Japan on the bottom of it. So I just thought that was cute. I found a vintage weird Furby. This one is huge. Very, look, it's as big as my head. It is very big. It is still has its original tag right there. You can see it is from 2005 and it has a rubber tongue. I have never seen one with a rubber tongue in it ever. So I need to put batteries in it to see if it works, which, oh, here. I'm like, where do you put the batteries in it? Yeah, right there underneath it. So I need to put batteries in it and test it to see if it works. But I just thought that was so strange. I've never seen a Furby with a rubber tongue like that, ever. So figured I'd take the chance on it. This will go into a treasure bag. It's a vintage ashtray from Minnesota. It'll go into a treasure bag. This cute little vintage framed piece. It looks old. I like the lady with her dog. Can you see that? I just thought that would look really cool on a gallery wall. So that will probably go into a pick three sale. I found two of these pins and I looked them up and they're decently, you know, they sell decent on eBay. So I figured why not? They are Blossom Bucket. So those are cool. Like those. Then I picked up this. It's just a weird little, I don't know, Eskimo? Is it an Eskimo? It's rubber. It doesn't squeak anymore. And it's not marked anything on the bottom of it, so I don't really know what it is, but it's pretty cool. It's like a rubber toy. Oh, and then this is Christmas, but it was too cute to leave behind. It's like one of those, nylon ornaments type things, like the string, you know, the thread. I don't know if that's exactly what it's called. You guys can correct me in the comments below, but that. This Amelia Earhart Festival pin. It's a little pin that will go into a treasure bag. See, I was thinking about putting some stuff back for a vintage toy bag, but if I don't have enough for the treasure bag, I might just go ahead and stick all the vintage toys in the treasure bag and just, you know, put it all. This is all tangled. This is a tangled mess. That needs some help, but it's a unique one. It's got the plastic wings. It's an old vintage one, and it's stamped on the bottom Hong Kong. So, yeah, that, it's a hot mess. Oh, I thought this was really cute. It's a rock. It's made out of all rocks. Like somebody glued and painted rocks and made a little girl. I thought that was a neat piece with her beaded necklace. She's got hairs on her. There we go. That's much better. She's cute. Oh, I picked up this. This is cute. Look at this trinket box. Cute little lovebirds. Aren't they adorable? There's no chips or cracks. It's got a sticker made in Japan. And I just thought those were so cute and adorable. Cute little trinket box. You could put your little trinkets in there. But a whole bunch of vintage hand towels. Well, before I get to the vintage hand towels, let's get to these. They're rolling away. I don't know what they were glued on, but they were glued on something. I couldn't find the bodies, but they're little heads. And I figured if somebody crafts, maybe somebody could, ooh, come on, Missy. If somebody crafts, maybe somebody could do something with them or something. I'm just going to go ahead and put them in a treasure bag because they're cute and adorable. So they're just three little heads. more toys real quick. There's Wilma. She'll go into a treasure bag and then a shoe. Treasure bag it. This little convex bubble glass frame. It's got its, you can either hang it up on the wall. See, it's got a thing. Or you could put this out and set it on your shelf with a picture in it. So I thought that was cool. Okay, so now to the towels. A whole stack of vintage hand towels. These are cool. My mom collects the, you know, these, but she's got so many she doesn't need anymore. There's a whole bunch of vintage hand towels. I will just show you really quickly. Fold them. So there's like that one. That one. That one. This one. This one. This one. And this one. Really, really cute vintage hand towels. So I'm probably just gonna lot them all up in one lot and sell them together as a vintage towel lot. I just think that would be so cool. That's what I'm gonna do. And then the last thing, I believe the last thing. Oh, here's the other pair of scissors. Treasure bag it. The last thing that I picked up. Nope. Little people. Treasure bag. Vintage little people. The last thing I picked up was this vintage San Marcos blanket. Now, if you know anything about blankets, you know that San Marcos is a good brand, an expensive brand, and a good brand to sell, a good brand to pick up, especially if you're a reseller. Where is the tag? There we go. San Marcos. Yay! I was so excited because these are hard to find out in the wild. For me, in my area, these are harder to find. This is a wolf blanket. I will lay it right out here and post a picture so you guys can see what it looks like all laid out and the size and stuff. And then I will put comps up here so you guys can see what they sell for. So yeah, I think I did very, very well for only spending $25 between this and then the birds, the Denmark birds. I think I did quite well. What do you guys think? How do you guys think I did? Really quickly, I'm gonna show you guys before I end the video, I went to an auction on Sunday. So really quickly, I'm gonna show you the things that I picked up because I didn't get a whole lot. I spent $16 at the auction. So I didn't get a whole lot, but I'm gonna show you what I did get. This scrapbook was in a crate full of just different books. This was right on top and I got this, I was so excited. It is full of vintage photographs. I think it's someone's senior scrapbook because it's got a bunch of different pictures in it. It's in rough shape. It's from the 40s. See, you can see parts, pieces of the paper falling apart. But it's from the 40s. It's got all kinds of different pictures in it. It's completely, completely full. Some of the pictures are loose, but some of them are intact. Like this, the date on the back of that says 1946. So this is somebody's scrapbook from the 40s and it is completely like full. There's cards in here, I believe. and photos and pick, well, I don't know if there's many cards, I guess. Mainly old black and white photos and scrapbook things. I don't know if you guys can see it or not, but like I said, it's in a little bit of rough shape. The back is not attached anymore to it. It's still there, but it's just not attached anymore. But isn't that awesome? That is so cool. Be a really fun piece thing to go through because it's full of vintage photos and stuff like that. And then this book was also in that crate, and I love this book. It is so fun. It is also really neat. It's full of art, like all kinds of different art. It is really, really cool, especially if you like art like I do. This is a neat book to go through. So this would be a really good coffee table book. And it's still got its plastic. Can you believe it? I would take the plastic off if I was going to set it on my table, but that's just me. And then I got this whole box full of vintage cake toppers. Now, some of them are weird. These are large. These are big ones in there. So I have no idea. Aren't they weird? Look at their faces. So those was in the box, but why I bought the box, I will show you here in just a second. Aren't those cute too? Those are adorable. Why I bought the box is because of these. There is a whole bunch of Halloween, vintage Halloween cake toppers in there. Tons of Halloween ones. So I will just show you a few of the different ones that are in there. Aren't they cute and adorable? They're so fun. And then there's Christmas ones as well. So there's a snowman one, and then there's a Santa one. Where did the Santa go? He's right here. There's so many. And then look at these ballerina ones. These are so cute. See, they're in little... I just thought those were so fun. There's tons and tons and tons. Little vintage scarecrow one. And then there's like people. There's Easter ones. Graduation ones. Just tons and tons, but I really, oh, look at that one. The Skull and Bones. That's cool. Yeah, I really like the Halloween ones. Those ones are my favorite. So there's tons of them in here, tons. The whole box is full. Oh, did I show you the kitty cat? The kitty cat one. Yeah, so that was a cool pickup. And then these were in a box of dolls. I thought they were really cute. They are actually perfect for the vintage Hawaii stuff that I picked up the other day. I've still got some left to sell, but they're like from Hawaii, vintage Hawaii souvenir pieces, but they're dolls. So these are so cute. His neck is a little bit floppy, but aren't they adorable? Those... This doll, she is a pajama girl. You can unzip her and put your pajamas in there and take her with you on your sleepovers. See, isn't she cute? Love her. Two bags of jewelry. We'll go through those here quickly in just a second. Cupies. Another Cupie. A metal ring holder. It's a kitty cat ring holder. A really cute Cupid planter. I thought that was adorable. It's numbered on the bottom. So I don't know if it's a Lefton or an Esco or what, but it's so cute with the angel. Love that. This wooden tray, hand-painted tray. I really like that. I thought it was an ashtray at first when I first seen it, and then I was like, oh, that's a hand-painted wooden tray. Really like it. It's very nicely done. This was in a little box full of stuff. It's a, I believe it's a rain cap. This cute little kitty cat mirror. And then two little pill boxes. I believe that's what, maybe this one's not because it's sticky. Maybe that one's a lip gloss one. I don't know. I need to wipe my finger off now. But that one's a little all crocheted or embroidered. But they're little metal boxes, so those are cute. This doll, mom said, told me what her name was, and now I can't remember. This little doll, baby beans. She's like full of beans. This I thought was cool. This is a pigeon forge pottery piece, which is cool because I was actually thinking about going to Pigeon Forge for my birthday and I still can't make up my mind. And then this is really fun. I need to put batteries in it to see if it works, but it's still brand new in its package. It's never been out of its package. Spinning poinsettias. These are so fun. They sing and dance and spin around and make noise. So that is what I got for $16. And then really quickly, I did get two bags of jewelry in that haul as well. I will just show you a few pieces out of here. This one I got because it had some really fun brooches in it. So there's like that. Whoa, I didn't notice that. Well, I don't know if that can be cleaned up or what, but because this was covered up, obviously, I just seen this part. But I thought that was a neat brooch. It does have wear. And this one was in there. It's missing a stone. Didn't notice it. Should have got some other ones. This one's pretty. That one's pretty. There's a butterfly. An enameled butterfly in there. It's missing some stones, but yeah, just all costume jewelry. I think I paid like $2 a bag, which isn't bad, you know. Here's, if you like baking, look at this one. Anybody like to bake? That one's in there. Oh, here's some grapes. These are pretty. Oh, missing one. Of course it is. That's what happens when you... I was looking at all these bags, too, before the auction. Like, before they were auctioned off. Before they got to them, I was looking at them. Oh, that's cute. And I seen some, maybe it's in the other one, I don't know, but there were some cool ones. Anyways, but it's a frenzy sometimes, you gotta hurry up and pick out stuff. Then this one I got because of this piece. I just thought this piece was cool. It's a locket. See, you can open it up. I thought that was really neat. There's a bunch of other things in there, too. I don't remember. Maybe Gordy gave me a different bag. I don't know. Anyways, two bags. So, yeah, I paid $16 for all that stuff. I don't think I did too bad. So, what do you guys think? How do you think my haul was today from the Goodwill bins and from the auction? Comment below and let me know what your favorite thing was that I found this time out of either one of the hauls. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If there's anything that you're ever interested in, you can always send me an email. My email is junktobeloved@gmail.com. All lowercase letters, no spaces. The link is in the description below as well. And I can let you know if it will be available in a live sale or if I'm willing to sell it outright. A lot of the things that you see me pick up will be available in my live sales, which I host right here on my YouTube channel every Sunday evening at 6 p.m. Central Time. So if you go subscribe right now and hit that bell button, you'll get a notification every time I go live and when I post new videos. And I'm going live tonight. If you're watching this video on Wednesday, I am going live here in just a little bit. For a fun pop-up live sale, selling lots of pixies and linens. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. As always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And until next time, keep smiling and happy picking. Bye, guys.